Hello, I'm Mr. Jure, retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. He came in 1469 and preached gospel through five more lives to perfection, 150 years, but still the darkness could not be comprehended. So very few people understand gospel. In India, one in a million, and in the West, one in a thousand and two in 10,000. So don't worry if you are solitary and seeking gospel. You have to be entering through the narrow gate into the royal kingdom of God. And here I'm rendering exposition of St. Luke 12:1-7. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, the same thing, you know. We have natural Father, this one natural, which is Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda. Our supernatural of soul, which is supernatural, is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So Jesus delivered the sermon to soul, delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call Satguru, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, that dwells within us, within our temple of God, called Harmandir, or Emmanuel. God is with us. So God is not outside, it is in here. At that time, so many people were crowding together that were trampling one another underfoot. He began to speak first to his twice born brethren or laborers. Jesus had no disciple. The root of the word disciple is discipline. The rabbi, Pharisees, Sadducees, they disciplined their disciple by teaching them the moral of Moses. So among the teachers, they have the disciple, which we call students, but not in Jesus. We are solitary. We don't follow Jesus. We join hands with him. Whatever comes out of his mouth, we hear it with the ear, take it to our heart, digest it through logical reasoning, and then we proclaim gospel. So it's our own proclamation. So twice born brethren, and not the once born disciples of the rabbis, beware of the leaven, that is the hypocrisy. And also remember that law and prophets, what tell John the Baptist, Luke 16:16. So transgression against the moral laws is called sin. So sin existed up to John the Baptist. Afterward, you know, is the era of Christ starts. Christ is the very source of light. And in that one, you go against Holy Spirit. As Ananias and Sapphira, they sold their possessions. They came to Peter, that's all they got it. They kept back money, colluding with each other. So what they spoke to Peter was not truthful. So it was hypocrisy, but that the Jewish people were doing. That is the level. And Peter killed them, both of them. So what is inside should be outside, like a little child. No hypocrisy. Then you get God inside here. Otherwise, you are Satan inside. Politicians, they are psychic. They are number one hypocrites. This Tony Blair and Bush, they said Saddam Hussein had weapons of mass destruction. And there was a major general in the army, retired, and he was there. And there is his card. And he came to give a sermon in Reading. And he told us, you know, he had no weapons of mass destruction at all. So it was a flat blasphemy against Holy Spirit, which rests in your heart. So you can see what type of politicians are leading your life. So be independent and be think yourself and not follow anyone. Blind people follow others. Beware of the leaven, that is hypocrisy or blasphemy against Holy Spirit, which is not forgivable. Like the sins are forgivable because they are man-made and man can forgive them. But the Holy Spirit, against Holy Spirit, God, you know, you can't be. That's why people are reaping the reward of that blasphemy now in America. This coronavirus and other thing is the production of Yahweh. Because lot of people of Yahweh, innocent one, they were killed by the bombing. Iraq, Libya, Syria and whatnot. So they have to repay it. They can't get rid of, they can't put it aside. So people should wake up and rebuke their politicians what they have done. They are killing the humanity. In Jesus we exercise love called agape, unconditional divine love. So this type of hatred is not tolerable in our Christianity. Which is not forgivable like the sins of the Pharisee. There is nothing concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. John 4, Gospel of Samaritan woman at well, she had five husbands, and those husbands, they were spiritual, and their names are, I have put them in the one of my Trinity. Their names were five, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. First is morality, which is opposite is immorality. Immorality you have to overpower. Then here, once more people, they can't understand gospel. So they get annoyed and they display anger. As Peter was one of them. As Peter did to Christ Jesus, he took him aside and started rebuking him. And here are the twice born people, and they are greed, money, Judas Iscariot. And here is the worldly attractions, third temptation of Satan to Jesus. Forget about God, I will give you all the kingdom which Pope is having, enjoying it, Antichrist. And here is haughtiness, that you are, have the spiritual knowledge, you become big, stiff-headed. Like these university professors do, that they have degree, doctor of this and that, they are stiff-necked. And when I ask them simple question, how many Jews died during the Holocaust, they can't answer it. Not a single Jew died in the Holocaust. Because Jew is the one who is inwardly, not outwardly. Spiritual self. So that's what the Samaritan woman said to Jesus, that you are a prophet. That means she was knowledgeable and she was humble, engaging Jesus in very deep discussion. Even his laborers, they were astonished, a woman speaking so spiritually high. And what about the men? Men would be much better. So, then she say, you are a prophet, and then she say, when Christ comes, he will tell us everything. That means she knew the difference between a prophet, and John the Baptist was a prophet, not a light, not a saint. So people have churches in the name of John the Baptist, calling him a saint. He was not a saint, he was an angel. Stephen was angel too, the first martyr. He was not a saint. Then she said, when she said that Christ will come tell us everything, but because she was knowledgeable, and longing for gospel. That's why Jesus said, I am the one. He disclosed to her without any hesitation. While in Jerusalem temple, these crook messianic Jews, are the Jews outwardly, super master fanatic devils, John 8 verse 44, they were taunting him, tell us if you are a Messiah or not Messiah. They could not even recognize him, as Samaritan woman did, that you are a prophet. And how can you tell the blind man that I am the light? You have to make fool of yourself. That's what he did. When he told them at last that he is the Messiah, the priest said, you know, for breaking the Sabbath, we won't kill you. But for saying that you are God, because Son represents Father, you are God Elohim, Allah Parbrahm, we must kill you. So they became his staunch enemy because they were saltless people. Unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, Jew outwardly of appearance, not of heart. And they are getting bundled up in Israel now for final burning. Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30 is getting fulfilled. So you can see the difference. Samaritans, they are salt of the earth people of Joseph's generation, whom they wanted to sell as a slave. Kill him, but sold him as a slave. And they hate him so much. He looked after them, everything. And they hate the generation so much that if you have to go to other part of the Jerusalem, which make it easier to go through the Samaria region, they won't go there. They will go outside, longer distance. They won't enter the Samaria villages. That is what they did to Joseph, who looked after them. That is called saltless people. Unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh. And by destroying the homeland of Abraham. Abraham is its Iraq, cradle of humanity. There is no doubt that they are saltless people. They have no respect for humanity. They are number one enemy of humanity, Mammon and media. So USA is a colony of Israel in disguise in Mammon and media. So whatever Israel tell them, they do it. So at that Saddam Hussein killed him, that was the wish of the Israel, that he is pointing gun at us. So they did it without any problem. So when Christ comes, he will explain everything. Therefore, whatever you have said in the darkness or pondered over logically to Brew Logo, yeah, you always, you know, ponder when you are at sleep at night, you know, then you wake up, you know, sometimes you ponder over his word, the answer come. When answer come, then you have to preach it to the public. And they will criticize you. When they criticize you, think about it. And try to renew your inner man. Inner man is Christ. I'm not a Christian, I'm a Christ. Inner man is Christ. And renew your inner man every day and you get the answer. No problem. So I have experienced these things. I ponder over in the morning or so when I'm asleep and I get the answer. So I then write it, make a video, YouTube video. will heard in the light. Ponder logically to good logo will be heard in the light, mean day in the public. Preach to other as an apostle. And what you have whispered behind closed door will be proclaimed on the housetop. That means in Jesus we don't whisper. We bravely shout at people. Or we openly do it as on the housetop. We are not frightened of anyone, because our head hair even are counted and all that, you know. So there's nothing to worry. I tell you, my friends, do not be afraid of those who kill the body. They kill the physical body, but after that can do no more. Now there was a saint, which was Shah Shams Tabreji. I was born in Multan, and in there is his grave, Kabar. So he took many births fighting against mullahs. Mullahs are sons of Satan in Islam, because in Islam it is submission of the will of Allah and not the wish of mullah. And also it is a Sharia free. This Sharia is of mullah. Mullah's Islam, not of Allah. Allah is all merciful. He doesn't think of evil of anyone. I tell you, my friends, do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but after that can do no more. So that Shah Shamsabrej took three births, I think my father told me, three births. And all the time he was killed, you know, by these mullahs. So nothing to be afraid of. Your soul carried the gospel treasures back to our father. Back to our father, that when father is see that this soul has brings gospel treasures, he is very happy. He is not, you can't say Lord, Lord, Lord and pray and boost his ego. God is spirit and serving. Lord don't serve. That's what the 10 virgins, first 5 went there, said, Abba, Abba, Father, Father. He opened the door, come in, sons. The other 5 went there, they wanted to boost his ego. Say, Lord, Lord, Lord. And our father said, I don't make slaves. I set people free, get lost. So he told them to close the door and told them, get lost. You can't go there. Your soul carried the gospel treasures back to our father. I shall show you whom to fear. Be afraid of the one who, after killing, has the power to cast into Gehenna. That is our father. You know, if you are not worthy, like those 5 virgins calling Lord, 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 they were called, thrown into Gehenna. They were the psychic people. Pneumatic went there. Yes, I tell you, be afraid of that one. Are not 5 sparrows sold for 2 small coins? Yet not one of them has escaped the notice of God. Even the hairs of your head have all been counted. Do not be afraid. You are worthy more than many sparrows. So when you are preaching the gospel, do not be afraid of anyone. If you twist it, afraid of the other people, you twist it like the hypocrites, then you fall into hell. My father used to preach gospel, you know, before partition. And many people were against him. In the Sikh temple, they did not like him. And in other places also, you know, they were looking with a strange, stern eye. But he wasn't bothered. We come from Jat tribe. Jat tribe are people like Samaritans. And we are outspoken. So he didn't bother, you know. So nobody hurt him. Nobody slapped him or anything. And one of our that person, he tried to speak bad language. And my father said, okay, if I've said anything wrong, you can say 10 times more to me. And then he went away. They are the once born people, they are easy stooges of the twice born people. And you have to be open-minded. Gospel is for twice born, unless you are capable of intuition, you cannot learn gospel. Our Father God blesses you all the best.